President Yoweri Kaguta Museveni has this morning returned to Uganda after successfully conducting a three-day state visit to Nairobi, Kenya. During the visit, the president held a fruitful meeting with His Excellency William Ruto, the President of the Republic of Kenya, as they discussed matters of mutual interest and explored opportunities for cooperation. The two leaders also engaged in bilateral talks with government officials from their respective governments. The discussions in general aim to further enhance collaboration in various sectors, including transport and infrastructure, trade and investment, immigration, regional integration, peace and security, and the fight against terrorism. At Jomo Kenyatta International Airport in Nairobi, President Museveni was seen off by Honorable Raila Odinga and the senior Kenyan government officials. On arrival at Entebbe International Airport, the president was received by the head of the public service and secretary to cabinet, Ms. Lucy Nachiove. The deputy commander of the Special Forces Command, Brigadier General Charity Bainababo, Uganda Police Director of Human Resource Development, AIGP Godfrey Golover, the Deputy Commissioner General Prisons, Mr. Samuel Akena, and Chief of Staff Air Force, Brigadier General David Gonyi. A human breast milk bank has been inaugurated in Bale Regional Referral Hospital with a call to mothers with excess milk to donate to the facility to help save premature babies in the country. Speaking during the launch of the facility, Dr. Stephen Obo, the Bale Regional Referral Hospital Director, said the milk bank acquisition is a timely one since the hospital has been grappling with high numbers of neonatal babies.
This is a new innovation, and to my knowledge, I think there is only one other milk bank in Uganda. And this is not in a public institution. This is a not-for-profit hospital in Kampala. In Bale Regional Referral Hospital, we have a neonatal intensive care unit. And in this unit, we care for a lot of infants or neonates who have been born. These are young babies who have either been born prematurely or are born with complications.
In her presentation during the inauguration of the milk bank, Dr. Kathy Bagoine, the neonatal lead at the Mbale Regional Referral Hospital, emphasized the categories of mothers who are eligible to donate breast milk to this facility.
We looked at all of our babies over a 12-month period. And what we found was when they were born, 40% of them were already malnourished. They were already born smaller than they were supposed to be, because of the complications in the mother.
Richard Mlagali, the commissioner in charge of Children's Desk at the Ministry of Health, say that whereas government has made strides in reducing infant mortality, the area of neonatal has still been a challenge. He said that with this innovation, the curve is to be reversed.
Newborn, the death of these small babies, I call them the voiceless. They can't talk. The death of these voiceless is the number one cause of death in Uganda. These voiceless babies are the leading causes of death. It's the age group that dies most in Uganda. For the newborns, it is very tricky. Sometimes it's not only surviving.
Mbale City political leadership, religious leaders, as well as cultural leaders have embraced the initiative and have promised to advocate for its advancement in the community in order to save lives of vulnerable infants. The breast milk bank was funded by the World Bank, supported by the Born on the Edge, a UK charity, alongside the Ministry of Health. Government hopes to replicate this innovation in other government facilities across the country. According to the Ministry of Health, Mbale was earmarked as a training center for the newborn care in Uganda following the vast numbers for babies in need of neonatal care. Census enumerators in Masaka District have been equipped with gumboots to aid access residents at the now flooded landing sites. This follows the rising water levels of Lake Victoria, which has flooded most of this landing site, rendering them inaccessible. The leaders in charge of the census in the district have expressed challenges encountered by the enumerators during the exercise. Among the challenges faced include the refusal by some of the community members to disclose the relevant information, such as the number of children and age. The community leaders say that some of the residents have already relocated to unknown locations due to displacement by the floods. This has made it difficult to obtain enumeration data as required. The data seek for an extension of the census days in order to cater for residents who have been relocated. Providing enumerators with gumboots came in handy because the access to these communities had been rendered nearly impossible.